Don't fear. Don't fear. Don't fear. God assureth, do not be afraid, was written over 150 times in the Bible. That's a daily reminder for us from God to live a fearless everyday life. Could it be because God knows one of the devil's main weapons against you and me is the weapon of fear? The next time you are afraid, you need to read Psalms 27. When the pressures of life is overwhelming and you are covered by the darkness of the fear of tomorrow, read Psalms 27:1. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When you don't know how it's going to turn out and you are worried on every side and trouble is coming to you from every single angle, you need to hold on to Nahum 1:7. The Lord is good, a stronghold in the day of trouble, and he knoweth them that trust in him. I have trouble here, trouble over there, and enemies all around me, but I refuse to fear. The Lord is my stronghold. Whenever you feel scared or anxious, maybe you have a job interview, or maybe you have an important presentation at work, remember Hebrews 13, verse 6. The Lord is my helper. I will not fear. What can man do to me? In times of distress and when you feel alone, recite Lamentations 3:55. I called on your name, O Lord, from the depths of the pit. You heard my plea. Do not close your ear to my cry for help. You came near when I called on you. You said, don't fear. In whatever situations you are facing, in whatever fear you are facing, regardless what the doctor's reports say, regardless what your accountant or school teacher or haters have said about your situation, do not fear, because the Lord is a stronghold in the day of trouble. Know that God is holding your hand, as Isaiah 41:13 says, for I, the Lord your God, hold your right hand. It is I who say to you, fear not. I am the one who helps you. Don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you. The word of God says, be strong and courageous. Do not fear or be in dread of them, for it is the Lord your God who goes with you. He will not leave you or forsake you. So you never have a reason to feel fear, because God is with you.
It feels like anything can happen, and we are all walking in uncertain times. And during uncertain times, that's when the spirit of fear begins to try drawing itself ever closer to us. But this is where, as a child of God, you need to draw the line and refuse to be fearful. So how do we overcome fear? We overcome fear with the Word of God. The Bible contains the promises of God, promises that I would like to leave with you to take away. These promises can provide you comfort. Comfort is definitely needed in these uncertain times that we are living in. So, I invite you, take notes. Isaiah 54. Fear is not a new phenomenon. In the Bible, there are many different stories where great men and great women of God became fearful. This explains why God encourages his children to fear not 365 times in the Bible. With everything going on in the world today, it is easy to become fearful. that even though situations may come at you, and you may feel overwhelmed, you must not lose faith in God, because God is in control. Here are 6 Bible verses that have changed my life. 1. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Isaiah 54, verse 17. No weapon formed against you shall prosper, and every tongue which rises against you in judgment, you shall condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is from me, says the Lord. I thank God that the verse does not say that no weapons will be formed against me, because that would be very disheartening, because weapons and situations always seem to be coming at me. God may allow some weapons to be formed, but even though these weapons are formed, these situations transpire. God wants to let us know that they will not successfully destroy us. So today, I am here to encourage you with this promise of God. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Whatever attacks the enemy has plotted against you will not defeat you. You need to make your mind up as a child of God. I will not be defeated. I will be strengthened, encouraged, motivated, vindicated, redeemed, but I will not be defeated. These words reside in my heart tonight. If we are God's people and God is with us and for us, then the plots of the enemy cannot defeat us because we are redeemed by the Lord. God is bigger than any trial or tribulation in life. He has power and sovereignty over all the earth, galaxies, and universe. God is all. If we are in God, we are in all. We are one. The Lord is in control. Even if things feel out of control, or simply out of our control, trust in the Lord that He is in control and has all the control. Simply give your life over to the Lord and rest assured that in uncertain times, the Lord will guide you. 2. The next verse I want you to keep is Psalm 34, verse 7. The angel of the Lord encamps all around those who fear Him and delivers them. If we believe in God, God will deliver us. We should not be afraid of our problems. We should not say, I wonder what this situation will do to me. But rather we should say, I wonder what my God is going to do in this situation. God encamps with us. We have nothing to fear. 3. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runneth into it and is safe. It is during severe storms, or even sad events in our lives, that we are forced to come to grips with reality and must ask ourselves, where is my faith? Or where is my trust? Is my faith and trust in myself, things, or other people? Or the name of the Lord, whom King Solomon describes as a strong tower, where we can run to and be safe from pain, harm, and danger? Sometimes God uses storms, fiery furnaces, and troubled waters to get us sailing in the direction we should have gone in prior to the storm. Believe it or not, but sometimes it takes a storm to know we are in need of shelter. It is in the storms in life where we are reminded of our desperate need of God. When the storms of life come, we need a shelter, a sure foundation called Jesus, to calm our storm. Jesus is indeed our hiding place. He is described in Psalm 46, verse 1, as a refuge, our strength, a very present help in times of trouble. The spiritual and mental storms which are unavoidable in all of our lives can be just as brutal and devastating as a physical storm, for they too are just as much a reality as a physical storm. They too cause us at times to feel fearful and hopeless when they begin to rage. It is the name of the Lord that is our strong tower. It is the place of safety which God promises to those who run to Him. Those who love and trust Him can run to Him for safety. Today, I exhort you to seek shelter in Jesus and Him alone. Seek Him through prayer and His word, for you will find a hiding place there. The Lord has not promised us that we will not have storms, but He promises to be a shelter in the time of them. The storm may be raging all around us, but we are given the promise of a secret place where we can run to in Psalm 91, verse 1. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. 4. Isaiah 41, verses 10 to 12. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. All who rage against you will surely be ashamed and disgraced. Those who oppose you will be as nothing and perish. Though you search for your enemies, you will not find them. Those who wage war against you will be as nothing at all. When God says, "Do not fear," I don't think it is an accusation of being irrational. When God says, "Do not fear," there is usually something that a normal person may be fearful about. But you are not normal. You are a chosen child of God. You should not fear. You see, someone who doesn't believe in God, his or her resources end with them. When a situation greater than his or her resources come, they can be afraid because they don't have a God in whom will strengthen or will help them. But you do. So, whatever your situation, no matter how much fear the situation calls for, do not be afraid. 5. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore. This psalm has been a great source of comfort and encouragement in very difficult times in my life. I would recommend that each of you listen to or read all of Psalm 121 during this time we are going through. Once the psalmist establishes where his help comes from, and now that you can be confident in the same God, he describes how God shows up for his people. God is always alert. Even when you're asleep, God is alert and ready to battle on your behalf. You can be confident that he never takes a break, but is right there, ready to act on your behalf. God always protects you. God is with you and will protect you. Whether it be in the desert or in the dark, it doesn't mean challenging things won't happen to you, but it does mean that he will watch over you and protect you. God is always with you. You can be sure that God will not walk away from you. In your comings and goings, God is with his people. You can call out to him and know that he is right there, ready to respond. 6. When thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee, and through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. You don't have to be afraid. We have our fears that we all face, fears that might stem from our inadequacies, fear of uncertainties or the unknown, fears of not turning out into what we thought we would be. The list is endless. Some people have fears about their health, a pain in their body, and they automatically fear the worst, without even seeing a doctor. Others have financial fears. Others have material fears, fearing their marriage will end in divorce. Others have, "Will I ever get married?" fears. Everyone has some sort of fear they have to face. The enemy wants you to live a life of fear. God is not against you. God is actively on your side. No one has your back the way God has your back. He is on your side. Paul is writing to the Romans, "If God be for us, who can be against us? Can devils? No. Can disease? No. Can sickness? No. Can calamity? No. Can distress? No. Nothing can separate you from the love of God." Romans 8, verses 38 to 39. "For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature, shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. God is for you. Remember, God is with you. Hold on to this one fact that He is with you, and you will make it all the way to eternity with this promise. God is your God. He is your Father. God promised you He will never leave you. Thank God He has assured us of His promises in His Word on the need to live above fears, because faith in God is one that empowers and gives us victory above fears and worries. He hasn't given us the spirit of fear, but the spirit of a sound mind, one that transcends that of a fearful heart. These promises were being tested in their situation. There was a value in holding on to these promises. These promises are not new, but they are tried and tested. So many have held on to these promises for comfort, and today I want to leave these promises with you. Keep these promises with you. Memorize them. Teach them to your children. Tell your friends. Because no matter what happens around you, God is still the same. May these promises return you to Him.